Hello and welcome to the next White Wall Wednesday. Today I am going behind the scenes on the editing from the image that we created together last week. If you recall, it was just me sitting in the tiniest little corner with a white wall and a floor, and that is it. There was nothing else going on in that space. So today I want to talk about three things in my Photoshop process. One is expanding the frame. So I'll talk a little bit about how the frame was expanded, what the pitfalls were, and what we need to look for when expanding the frame. The next thing that I want to talk about is adding some believability to the image. So creating some separation between your subject and the background by darkening the background and adding light to your subject, and also adding in elements that weren't there before that are going to drastically enhance the image in terms of believability, the story, and drawing the viewer in. So let's go over to the screen and we are going to do some live editing here, both watching the speed edit of when I edited this image, as well as a few little moments that I feel need a little bit of extra attention. While I let the edit run from the edit that I did on this image previously, I'm going to show you these two images right here and how I put them together as you see the speed edit of how it actually went when I was doing the live actual thing. So the first thing that I want to do during this portion of the edit is to use the crop tool. It's sort of counterintuitive because the crop tool not only crops, but it also expands the frame. So instead of working on my locked layer, I'm going to duplicate that layer really fast there just to make sure we're working in a really clean way. And I'm actually going to take the crop tool, which automatically brings up this dotted line and these little more solid spaces where you can pull. As you see, when I start pulling, it starts to expand the frame. Whatever color swatch is underneath is the bottom one here. That's going to be the color that fills in the background. So I can expand this frame in any direction that I want to. It's okay if it's not in the ratio that you want or if it doesn't look quite right with the composition, because you can always crop more, say okay, pull it back out. Whatever you think needs to happen is totally fine. The next thing that I want to do is grab this image that I know that I want to include in with the other image that I have here. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to go ahead with my move tool, click and drag to get that image over. Now there are a couple ways that I can match this up. My favorite way is to lower the opacity on my layer here and pop it into place by matching up lines or anything that looks like really recognizable in the image. So I can see that this needs to come down here. I can see that it's warped in the wrong direction, and that's because I tilted my camera, but that's gonna be okay. So I'm going to take the opacity back up, create a layer mask. I'm going to erase really quickly here at 100% opacity with a soft brush, just until I have my subject showing through. Okay, now I can see that the floor isn't doing so bad, but up here it's getting more and more warped. So I'm going into Edit, Transform, Warp, and I am going to start to pull at the edges or in the boxes here to try to warp everything into place where it needs to be so that it lines up. Does it need to be absolutely perfect? No. We can fix some of this later, but as long as it lines up well enough now, I'm good to go. The next thing that I need to think about here is the color tone. Clearly there's a shadow here, but there's not a shadow here. So I'm going to go ahead with my adjustment layer through curves. I'm going to pin that layer down to the wall that we're working on just to make it a little bit darker. Now you can do this in any way you see fit. If you prefer to use exposure, you can do it that way. There's no right or wrong way, but I like curves personally. So I'm making that just a little bit darker so then it blends in. And we have the start of a wall and a floor that's been expanded. As you can see, it wasn't there before. Something else that I want to do here is begin to get rid of this window, because I really don't need any extra distractions in this picture. I already plan on having a hole in the ceiling, so I don't need a window distracting me. So in that case, I'm just simply going to clone. Cloning is a matter of transforming pixels from one spot to another. Pretty simple, so I'm going to define a point and then color those pixels wherever I want them at 100% opacity. I'm not paying too much attention here to the tonality, if it's too dark, if it's too light, if there's a shadow crisscrossing somewhere. That's not really my concern. My concern is that I am sort of moving smooth pixels from one space to another. And I'm going to go ahead and worry about smoothing the pixels out in this next step with my heel brush tool. So I'm taking the heel brush tool, taking the size up a little bit, defining a source point just like the clone stamp, and I'm going through and blending by just drawing it right over the spaces where there's a tonal shift. Now this is going to take some time, so you'll see it in the speed edit as I move through the different patchy areas of the edit. This is the file that I worked on when I edited the image by myself, and I wanted to open this up to this stage because this is the point where I felt like I had the walls and the floor and the ceiling sort of expanded to the point where it looked smooth enough. It's not perfect by any means, and there's this squiggly line of the cable cord that was running through my building that makes everything look especially uneven. And then I have a little bit of like a little curve here and just a few inconsistencies that need to be smoothed out, which do get smoothed out later in the edit. But for now, I wanted to share a little bit of what my thought process was from this point on. It's so important that when you're using image compositing, it's not only about the composite, it has to be about the story too. But we get so caught up sometimes in, oh my God, does it look perfect? Is anybody going to notice this flaw? That we don't think about, well, is it actually telling the story in the most appropriate way possible? So from this point on, I started to do a few things. One was I used a stock image, which I don't do very often, but I do if I'm having trouble finding the right looking element. So in this case, it was the hole in the ceiling, which I purchased so that I was able to use it freely. And I found this sort of hole that I really liked, and it didn't quite fit yet. So I decided to change it a little bit to make it brighter, whiter, so that it looked like it really was underneath the plaster of the ceiling. So that's one thing that I did. And then I decided, well, you can't have a hole in the ceiling without seeing what's on the other side. So that's when I added in clouds. And I made them quite a bit brighter because it would make sense that anything outside is going to be much brighter than what's inside. If I'm exposing for what's inside, the outside has to be too bright. So that was my thought process there. And you can see a little bit more of, for example, the cable going away, some of what I started doing with the shading, which will make sense as the debris starts falling. This is a really important step as well, which brings me to point number two about compositing for this video, which is this. If you want your subject to stand out and you want the location to not be so much of the focal point, then do whatever you can to make your subject brighter and your background darker, especially with a white wall. So in that case, I am simply, with all of these little steps that I'm putting on, I'm working on creating a vignette, creating a stream of light, and really changing how we read the light in this image. It makes a really big difference with how we see the subject, how we see the background, the location, and what kind of story we're reading into this image. Many of the techniques that I'm using here, especially these big vignette, big beams of light that are coming in, are simply to use the lasso tool, draw in wherever you want the light, feather that selection, and then create an adjustment layer. When you're image compositing, especially when you're working in a really boring space, it's very tempting to add elements into the image to make it more interesting and to draw the viewer in to somehow interpret the story. In this case, that element for me was the dust falling from the ceiling. It's one thing to edit a hole into the ceiling because that's one concrete object mixed with another. In compositing, you start to become very aware of what will be simple to add in and what will be very difficult. Some difficult things include cutting hair out from a background. Other things include see-through fabric. Anything that isn't completely solid is going to be inherently more difficult to add into an edit. In this case, it was the dust and particles that I had coming down through the ceiling. So I'll show you a couple of those elements being added in. Here we have some dust. And this is a combination of smoke. This one in particular is smoke that I photographed on a black backdrop that I was able to isolate by, as you see, if I click this layer with the smoke, my blending mode is on screen. So that's allowing me to take away the dark background that this image once had, the smoke once had, and to isolate the lighter color. Here I am adding in baby powder and combination of flour for some of these. And you can see in particular on some of these when I zoom in, you can see the little particles, and it's just baking flour that I'm tossing in the air and baby powder and setting off smoke emitters and things like that to add in this effect of debris coming down through the hole in the ceiling. All of these are done by shooting on a black backdrop and then choosing a blending mode. For example, this one is on darken, this one is on screen, and so on. And it's just up to you to see which blending mode works best for those tricky elements that you're trying to add in to your image. Some of the finishing touches for this image were to refine the light even further, add light and color coming in, putting texture into the image, and then as you can see in these final really big curve adjustments, making those huge lighting changes so that the subject really is our focal point. I think that changing the color of the dress really helped that, since this wasn't a monochrome image, which it was really threatening to begin with that gray dress. The ceiling has a lot of character to it now. You can see some color coming in, but mostly it blends right in. And what we've really done here is we've disguised the space. Yes, we shot in a very simple, tiny little space, but we transformed it by expanding the frame outward, getting rid of the windows and the distractions that were there, and adding in the elements that I wanted to see present and as the focal point within this image. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope that you learned something or just got a little bit of insight into my process. I can't wait to share more White Wall Wednesdays with you, and we're going to get back into shooting next week, especially talking about spaces that you can utilize as they are, creating something with the space you have available. And then later on in the series, we're going to talk about how to totally overhaul the image and move somebody to a totally different background. I'm very excited to share this with you, and please leave a comment below. Let me know if anything in particular helped, if it was interesting, if it wasn't interesting, because I make these to share my life with you a little bit, so I just want to hear a little bit from you. If you have worked on a white wall picture this week, please post it in the comments. I am so excited to see what you guys are doing with that type of creativity, pulling from within and letting it come out in the most boring, uninspiring place that we are turning into something amazing. Have a wonderful week, and I will see you next Wednesday.